Hi guys, Radhika here with another video. So today's video is on the golden child. So the golden child is narcissist's favorite child. So I know this is bad because usually people don't pick amongst children. And that's what it should be. We should not pick amongst children, but that's what a narcissist will do. So a golden child in this sense is not just always a child. It's like a golden person. So if you have a narcissistic boss, you will see that there is a particular person in the team that the narcissistic boss is more nicer to, or they are more they will approve more of the golden person's ideas, or they will idealize this golden person. They will talk nicely about this person to everyone. So they will kind of keep on promoting this person. Secretly, the narcissist controls the golden child. So it's in a way the narcissist is promoting himself. Because what the golden child does is to a large extent dictated by the narcissist. So the narcissist is playing this dual game of trying to be like a generous person, talking nicely about a third entity like the golden child. But the golden child is actually doing the narcissist's bidding. So that's the hidden agenda behind it. Also, the narcissist wants adulation, right? The narcissist craving adulation. So he craves adulation from this golden child. And the golden child keeps giving him adulation because that's the narcissist is promoting the golden child. So it's like a symbiotic relationship between the two. And it can also be a narcissistic grandparent who sees a lot of themselves in one of the grandchildren. So they will pick that child as the golden child. So the child here is really in a narcissistic family, but it could be anyone, any person basically that the narcissist picks to be overly nice to. So a golden child can do no wrong. Whatever the golden child does is all right. So that's what I was telling you, like ideas that a person gives will be promoted, the golden child gives will be promoted, their behaviors will be modeled as ideal behavior. If they do something wrong, it will be completely ignored and just let go of. They won't even talk about something bad that the golden child does. It's like it never existed. No one did it. So the narcissist treats the golden child as the narcissist wants to be treated. Even when the narc does something bad to you, they ignore it, right? They completely deny anything like that happened. They do the same to the golden child. So the golden child is actually being trained into becoming a narcissist by the narcissist parent or boss or grandparent, whoever. Or even like in a friend's group, if it's run by a narcissist, he will choose like another person who's gonna be the golden person, and that person's gonna do all the bidding for this narcissist. So, and the narcissist, a lot of time they do this because they see a lot of themselves in that other person. So they kind of relate with that other person over this similarity. So it's not really a love-based relationship. It's more like an ego-based relationship. So say I like eating, I'm a narcissist and I like eating spicy food. So if I see amongst, say I have five children, and I see that one of them, or five is too much, say I have three children and one of them likes eating spicy food. So suddenly I'm going to be like, oh, this kid likes eating spicy food, so he or she is more like me. So as soon as I see that similarity, I fall in love with it. So not love, but it's like an ego bond, you know, I feel like oh, this is like me. If it is like me, so it's great. You know, you get that kind of a thing. So it's an egoic bond. It's not a love bond. So the narcissist does not love the golden child. They see a lot of themselves in the golden child. So they recognize it and they immediately start elevating this kid to a higher status in this family, or they or in this company, or in the team, or so on and so forth in different relationships. And what the narcissist is doing is they are basically trying to elevate themselves. So they do this elevation by association kind of a thing. So they are feeding off even the adulation that this person is getting. And because of them, say it's an office environment and the boss praises a particular employee because he sees a similarity between him and that employee. And now that he has started this word around that this employee is a great person, that employee might be a great person. They might do a good job at their job. So someone might come and praise this person back to the narcissist that, oh, he did so and so for my team and it was really great. And the narcissist will feel so proud. They will feel so proud, not because that person is being praised and not because they love that person. They will feel proud because they will understand this. They will understand their whole game in their mind and they will feel that, oh, this quality was what I recognized in him. I praised him to everyone and now this gossip is coming back to me. So now everyone believes this is a great person and now I can control this person and do whatever I want. So in a way, the narcissist is just trying to acquire more power and acquire more adulation to feed his own ego, his or her own ego. So this is what a golden child's purpose is in the narcissist's life. Also, when the golden child is an actual child or even otherwise, the golden child, if that person is naive, they will really love the narcissist. That's the sad part. They will really love the narcissist with not with an egoic bond, but with a real heart-based connection. And it's really sad that the narcissist will make this golden child do even a lot of bad things because the narcissist will use them as a puppet to do those bad things. And the golden child will keep going back to the narcissist because they love them and for they have gotten into this programming of seeking an approval from the narcissist for everything they do. So they will continue this cycle of seeking approval. So it's kind of sad for the golden child. Now the narcissist will use the golden child, as I mentioned before, to spread negativity. So the golden child will very soon start mirroring the behaviors of the narcissist. And this happens. It happens a lot. So the narcissist will project their own emotions and their own their intent to act onto the golden child. And the golden child will take it on and they will run with it. And they won't even think about it because they have been programmed that way. So that's why the golden child might do a lot of bad things in life, like differentiate between people and say bad things to certain people, act in certain ways, act entitled. And it's actually all the programming that the narcissist is giving to this golden child. And they are in turn actually creating another narcissist. So the golden child is like a narcissist who's learned from, you know, a maestro. So they have learned from a mastermind how to play this narcissist game. And this programming is actually all subconscious. It's not on the conscious level. That's why people don't realize it. They don't. They just do things and they say things and they feel super entitled. They feel that they are doing the right thing. They really feel that they are doing the right thing. It's ridiculous how like true this is, but they feel like they are doing the right and the just thing, and only if they could like get out of themselves for a moment and look at this from a top view, they would understand what their life is all about. But the truth is, there are a lot of golden child children who are in their 40s who become a narcissist themselves, and they still keep their narcissistic parents are like 60 now, and the 60-year-old parent controls the 40-year-old child. And it is true, it is happening. It is happening in so many homes right now. And the narcissistic, the golden child does all the bidding for the narcissistic parent. And they break families. They really do. They break families. They break people. They put people in depression. They put people through so many negative emotions because they are unaware of what is happening to them. And they never stop. They don't stop. They don't take a step back. They don't look at what is happening around them. They don't look at their life. They don't review their life. If only they sat down and they saw what has been happening all throughout their lives, they would get a view into, they would get an insight into narcissism. You know, they would not need these videos. They would just get it. They would just get that they are being controlled. It's like they have gotten into this robotic trance, you know, where they just keep on doing things that the narcissist tells them to do, and the narcissist is whispering in their ears all the time. And I see this a lot, it's really sad. So the golden child, let me just look at my notes. So the golden child is a great supply to the narcissist for his or her narcissistic supply. They still get adulation, they get love. When they are acting out, the golden child will take them out, make them feel good again. So they keep doing this. And this especially happens in a parent-child scenario when the spouse of the narcissist has checked out long time back. They are in their own world, they are relaxing, they are listening to music, they are doing spirituality, they are doing meditations, they are going on retreats, and the narcissistic parent has been left with the child. And the spouse of the narcissistic parent is free now, but the golden child has taken on the role of the supporter of the narcissistic parent. So, yeah, so that's what it is. And because they have been programmed from childhood by their narcissistic parent, they keep doing the things that they were programmed to do, and they never really understand their programming. They will probably understand it once they themselves are old. Or I see a lot of people who are just narcissists, who are trained by narcissists to be golden children, and after the parents die, they themselves become a narcissist and they continue the same thing. So the cycle of just negativity and just this dysfunction, it keeps on continuing if you don't take a step back and look at it from a rational, from a psychological, from a spiritual point of view. What is happening, it will keep on happening. Many times a golden child will also understand this programming, especially if they are kids and if they see this happening and if they are being taught two different things. So say in the school, they are being taught that we should not discriminate between human beings. We are all special. We are all equal. And they come home and they see a narcissistic grandparent who is treating them specially, who is treating them in a special way, and say who's treating their sibling in another way, who's always shouting on the sibling, but this child gets special treatment. And sometimes the child knows that sometimes the child has done something bad, and as children, children are very instinctive. They know in their gut, they know, have they done something bad, have they done something good, and they see things very clearly. They see contradictions, they see hypocrisy, they see all these things because they pay attention to everything very minutely. So say the the golden child has done something bad, and they see that this grandparent actually did not scold me. They didn't scold me for this bad thing that I did. But my sibling, even if he does a small bad thing, he is being scolded a lot. And so this golden child, when they do the bad thing, they will get scared because they will feel, oh, a scolding is coming for me. But when they don't get scolded, they have two paths that they can choose. They can either feel great and entitled that I did not get scolded, so I am great. Or they can take the other path, which is like, in which their reasoning is like, no, but we all are equal. Why is my brother or my sister being treated like this? And why am I being treated specially? And if that child has that sense of justice, of equality, then the child is actually going to get saved and they are not going to become a narcissist. They might have certain tendencies of narcissism, because narcissism is a spectrum. It can vary. You know, malignant narcissists or people who have narcissistic personality disorder are malignant, but not all narcissism is malignant. We need a certain degree of narcissism to survive in this world. So that child actually has the power to choose then which way he or she wants to go. So every golden child can take two ways. Either they can become a narcissist or they can become an empath, and they can choose equality and goodness for all. And such a child, if the child realizes that, or even in an office situation, if an employee realizes that this boss is giving me special favors and they stop it right there, then you have a chance of stopping injustice, of stopping this cycle. So even if you are a golden child, you have this chance of stopping, that you can stop the narcissist from controlling you, from running your inner life, from running the voice in your head which says, oh, I'm great, I deserve special treatment. So you can stop that. So this is what I had to say on Golden Child. And if you know any golden children, if you know incidents like this, please put it in the comments below. Please do like, subscribe and share these videos. And I wish you all a lot of love and a lot of light. Thank you. Bye.